Góðan daginn, or góða kvöldi, depending on when you are watching this. Today I'm going to talk about Icelandic names. So I bet you've all seen these Icelandic names that end with dóttir and so on. And today I'm going to go a little bit over the basic of the logic behind this, but I'm also going to include some vocabulary and some phrases that we use when we talk about names in general. So hopefully this lesson will be useful both for people who know nothing about Iceland and also for people who know a little bit more. So let's just get started. First of all, I'd like to teach you the basic question. Hvað heitir þú? Hvað heitir þú? Which means, what are you called? What is your name? Or anything along this line. Where the verb að heita means to be called something or to have the name of something. And it's the same as you have in German when you say ich heiße, and same when you have in Scandinavian. And you also have the equivalent in Spanish when you say me llamo, etc, etc. So basically you have this verb in most languages, but not in English for some reason. There's also a slightly modified version, but not drastically, because in lesson number 19, doesn't matter if you watched it or not, but in lesson 19, I mentioned that if you're asking a question, then you can combine the verb with the pronoun. So instead of saying hvað heitir þú, you can also say hvað heitirðu. Hvað heitirðu. So these two versions, it's basically the equivalent of saying I am versus I'm in English. But at this moment, you can just choose whatever version you like the most and use that one. So you can either say hvað heitir þú or hvað heitirðu. Both completely equivalent. Then when you get this question, then you will answer ég heiti Ása. Ég heiti Ása. And except that you will put your own name, not my name, but you get the drift. Hvað heitirðu? Ég heiti Boop. Easy as that. Okay, so now let's talk about Icelandic names a little bit more general. Okay, so as an example, I'm going to pick up a guy. So this made-up person is a man, and he has the name Jón Ólafsson. There are several things that are unusual when it comes to Icelandic names. First of all, is that we use the first name as the main thing. Okay. So when you look somebody up in the phone book, like online now, but in the olden days on paper, then this person would be alphabetized under J, because we're alphabetized by our first names, not our second name, not our family names or our last names. It's always by the first name. So what does it mean, Jón Ólafsson? Jón Ólafsson basically means that Jón is his first name. And the son part of the name means just as he's the son of somebody that's called Ólafur. So his last name comes from the first name of his father, and then you add son at the end. Okay, so basically his name is Jón, the son of Ólafur. This is his name. And this is also sort of why we don't use the last name so much. It's a bit weird if you start calling the son of Ólafur, the son of Ólafur. It's a bit, I don't know, at least we don't do it so much. So basically in Iceland, you will always, always, always call people by their first name. Always, always, always. Or alternatively, by their entire name or by their full name, which we call fullt nafn. And on top of that, Icelandic people don't really use words like Mr. and Mrs. or anything like this. We don't even use things like doctor or something like this. So Jón Ólafsson will always just be called either Jón or the full name, Jón Ólafsson. He will never be called only Ólafsson unless he goes abroad. But in Iceland, this will never happen. And this means also sort of if you're in a somewhat formal situation, like let's say you're waiting for the doctor and somebody calls out your name at the doctor's office, most likely you will just be called Jón. Jón. There would be no Mr. Olafsson. It's just Jón. But maybe because Jón is the most common name in Icelandic, they might add the full name and say Jón Olafsson, but that's as formal as they're going to get. And maybe for this reason, we have a sort of a funny word that I don't think exists in English, and I'm not sure that exists in any other language, and that is a nafni. Nafni. And that means sort of like a name brother, like any person that has the same name as you and is male, you will call nafni. So for example, let's say that Jón Olafsson has a cousin who's called Jón Guðmundsson, and then when they meet each other, they might say, "Ah, hi nafni, hello nafni," and you can use nafni sort of like a pal or a friend or like, "Hey bro," or whatever like this. It's a very friendly way to greet somebody. So it's like, we share this connection, we have the same name, you are my nafni. Ah, fantastic. But now let's imagine that our main protagonist, Jón Olafsson, he finds a lovely girl and they fall in love. So basically, Jón Olafsson meets this person that's called Anna Sigrun Gunnarsdóttir. Let's call her Anna Sigrun Gunnarsdóttir. Okay, and they fall in love. And contrary to normal Icelandic traditions, they marry before they have the children. Okay, so let's just marry them. So blub, they're very happily married. But of course, Anna will not change her last name, because Anna Sigrun Gunnarsdóttir, she is the daughter of Gunnar. And this will not change when she is married, okay? This will obviously not change, because her last name is not like a family name in that sense. It's just telling you whose daughter she is. So basically, when you get married, your father doesn't change. So Icelandic people, when they get married, as a rule, they don't change their last name. They're still the same. So Jón Olafsson and Anna Sigrun Gunnarsdóttir, they are now married, but this has no impact on their names whatsoever. And now if Anna Sigrun has a person that's called the same name as she has, maybe she has a small niece that is called Sigrun, then she would be her nafna. Okay, nafna. So nafna means like a name sister. Somebody female who shares the same name as you is a nafna. And as you can see, it doesn't matter if like Anna Sigrun has Sigrun as the second, like the middle name, and the small niece has Sigrun as a first name. This doesn't matter at all. As long as the name is there, you have the permission to call each other nafna. Okay, and this is a very sort of friendly status, and it's a nice thing to say, especially to small kids, but just in general. However, if Anna Sigrun Gunnarsdóttir would meet a person that's called, let's say, Margrét Gunnarsdóttir, this means nothing. Having the same last name, this means nothing. This is completely meaningless. It just means that your fathers have the same name and that you don't care. Now let's imagine that Jón and Anna Sigrun, they have a kid and it's a boy. Yay! And they decide to name it Ólafur. Okay. Olafur, just to show how it works. Then, according to traditional Icelandic things, his last name would be Olafur Jónsson. Okay? Olafur Jónsson. Because he takes the first name of his father and then puts son to it, because he's Jón's son. So it's basically Olafur, the son of Jón. Olafur Jónsson. Small grammatical side note here is that you don't, as you might have noticed, that you don't just put the name and then you put son to it, but actually you have to do some grammar with the name, because what we are actually doing, Jónsson, it actually means John's son. Okay, so we are actually putting the word into the same grammatical form as you would in John's. So that's why you have the extra S. Okay, so that's why it's Jónsson with two S's, because Jóns means Jóns in English, and then son means a son. Okay, and by now you might have noticed a pattern, and this is a pattern that is very popular in Icelandic naming. is that our main hero, Jón Ólafsson. He has a son that's called Ólafur Jónsson. And now if his son would have a son, then he could name him Jón Ólafsson. And then the grandfather and the grandson would have exactly the same name. And then he would be his alnafni. Alnafni, which means totally the same name, everything the same. And as you can imagine, this is because we don't have any sort of last names that go on from generation to generation. Many families do this, like they alternate between, like one generation names their boy Ólafur, the next generation names their boy Jón, and then it's like Ólafur Jónsson Jón, Ólafsson Ólafur Jónsson Jón, Ólafsson Jón, Ólafur Jónsson Jón, Ólafsson, for generations and generations. And now Jón and Anna Sigrun have a daughter. Let's name her Hrefna. Okay, so then Hrefna Ósk, that sounds nice. So then the daughter would automatically be named Hrefna Ósk Jónsdóttir. Okay, Hrefna Ósk Jónsdóttir. So then you see that we have a family of four people, and none of them have the last name. And this is completely normal in Iceland. This is completely, completely normal. Okay. Because Jón, he's the son of Ólafur. Anna Sigrun, she's the daughter of Gunnar. Ólafur is the son of Jón. And then, what did I name her? Hrefna Ósk, she's the daughter of Jón. So, the last name alternate if you're a woman or if you're a man, and then just depends on who is your father. So it's very natural that you have many, many different names like this. With feminism more recently, and also sometimes in the past when the fathers were not in the picture or where the fathers were not known, you can also name after the mother. So let's now say that Jón and Anna Sigrun decide to have one last kid, but boo, they have twins. Oh, so now suddenly you have four kids. So then they decide to name the twins Gunnar after Anna Sigrun's father, and then Rosa after Anna Sigrun's mother. Okay. And then Anna Sigrun says, we named the first kid after you. I had to carry twins for 9 months, so now let's name the second kids after me. And then the kids would be called Gunnar Önnusson. Gunnar Önnusson, and then Rosa Önnudóttir. Rosa Önnudóttir. So that way you can very easily have a family, or fairly easily, I don't know how easy it is to have four kids, but fairly easily you can have a family with six different last names. Okay, because it's not a family name, it just tells what gender you are and who's your father. I think it's a part because of these naming conventions, but in Iceland it is very, very common to name your kid after somebody. Usually you name them after your parent or anyone else you know. It is very common. So in Icelandic we have this kind of funny phrase that is difficult to translate directly, but if you directly translate it, the phrase is að vera skýrður í höfuðið á. Okay, að vera skýrður í höfuðið á. Okay, and in our example, Ólafur skýrður í höfuðið á afa sínum. So literally this translates as Ólafur is baptized into the head of his grandfather, or like in the head of his grandfather. I don't know how to say this in English, but basically this means that he is named after his grandmother. And in the same way, you can say Rosa skýrð í höfuðið á ömmu sinni. Rosa skýrð í höfuðið á ömmu sinni, which means Rosa is named after her grandmother. And in case that wasn't clear, in Icelandic, when we talk about baptizing somebody, we say að skýra, and in daily talk, we you should also for giving somebody a name, because typically when you baptize somebody, you announce the name. So in daily talk, even though that's strictly not correct, we say Alskira when we refer to giving a baby a name, regardless of whether they're baptized or not. Note here that the word skirður, which means baptized, it changes depending on the gender of the person. So if it's a male, you would say skirður. If it's a female, you would say skirð. And if it's a neutral gender or a non-binary, then you would say skirt. For example, you could say yngsta barnið skirt í höfuðið á ömmu sinni. Because a baby or a child is a neutral word, then you would say barnið skirt í höfuðið á ömmu sinni. Okay. But to avoid these gender issues, you can also say hann heitir í höfuðið á afa sínum and hún heitir í höfuðið á ömmu sinni, which basically means he is called in the head of his grandfather, or like in natural speak, he is named after his grandfather and she is named after her grandmother. But of course, not everyone is named after their grandparents. Some people just get their names out of nowhere. And of course, Icelandic people also have a phrase for this. So let's take, for example, our lovely child, Hrefnaósk. So Hrefnaósk wasn't really named after anyone. She was just named Hrefnaósk because the parents liked the name. And in Icelandic, we then say, hún skýrð út í loftið. Hún skýrð út í loftið. Or alternatively, if she were a guy, hann skýrður út í loftið. And the baby, barnið, skýrt út í loftið. And literally this means she is named out into the air. It's like, woo! It's like so wild. She's like named out to the air. The name just came from the air, out of nowhere. Here is a summary of what we talked about today. Press pause and read it at your own speed. In the first homework of today, I want you to answer this question with a full sentence. Hvað heitir þú? Hvað heitir þú? Press pause if you need it. Otherwise, I will give you the answer now. The answer to the question Hvað heitir þú is ég heiti, and then you put your name. In the second homework of today, we have a new protagonist who's called Haraldur Guðmundsson. And now I have a list of six people and I want you to find what relationship these people have to Haraldur Guðmundsson. If you're unfamiliar with Icelandic naming conventions, this might be a little bit tricky, but if you manage to do this, you have mastered everything there is to know about Icelandic names. Press pause, take all the time that you need, and now I will give you the answer. So here is the result. If anything is unclear, don't hesitate to leave a comment. Otherwise, stay tuned for the spjall. Eins og margir Íslendingar, þá ég skýrð í höfuðið á ömmu minni, sem hét líka Ása. Við þó ekki alnöfnur. Nafnið Ása hvorki mjög algengt, né mjög sjaldgæft, bara svona venjulegt. Og það sama má segja föðunafni mitt. Pabbi heitir nafni sem ekki mjög sjaldgæft, en heldur ekki mjög algengt. Það sem skrítið við nafni mitt það að ég heiti bara Ása. Eina nafni mitt Ása. Ég heiti ekki tveimur nafnum. En flestir á Íslandi, sérstaklega undir 50 ára eða svo, hafa tvö nöfn. Og það mjög óvanalegt að hafa bara eitt nafn sem þar auki svona stutt. En þrátt fyrir það, að ég heiti bara einu nafni sem ekki mjög sjaldgæft og að pabbi minn heiti nafni sem ekki mjög sjaldgæft, þá í sögu Íslands bara ein kona sem hefur verið alnafna mín. Ég fletti henni upp fyrir löngu síðan og vissi í hvað bæ hún bjó. Svo fyrir algjöra tilviljun fór ég að vinna í þessum bæ. Svo þegar ég nýbyrju að vinna, þá kemur kona upp að mér og spyr mig hvað ég heiti, ég svara og það fyrsta sem hún segir ekkert meira nása, heitur ekkert meira nása og ég mjög vel að svara þessari spurningu, skal ég segja ykkur, þegar sem krakki var ég alltaf spurð hvort að ég heiti ekki eitthvað meira nása því það svo stutt og ég útskýrði þolin móð að ég heiti bara ása og svo eftirnafni eftir pappa mínum og það væri ekkert meira. Þá brosir hún og segir, heyrðu, mamma mín, hún alnafna þín. Og svona Ísland lítið.